Right. YouTube video uploaded at 1:30 in the morning. That's because we're about to go to the airport. We are going to Prague for the first ever time. I look so tired. But I am in the office and I'm ready to go. So let's go to the airport. 3-hour journey, I think. Jesus. It's way too early for this. So we're going to Prague. It's 2 in the morning and we've got to get to Gatwick for about 5 in the morning. I've never done an early morning flight before. We've always done afternoon flights because of this reason. When we're not morning people. It's just not very good at waking up in the morning and doing this. So this is the first time for everything, as always. But it was one hell of a deal and we couldn't let it down. So yeah, we're going to Prague. So let's go.
You have arrived.
Now, will it recognise the plate?
Oh!
Yeah!
Three.
Perfect. Ah, well that was definitely needed. Normally I wouldn't leave these because I know how hard it is to grow. And you can find that video on the channel or in the description below where we grew our own veg. And that's something that everyone can start doing themselves. But I would have had them, but they exploded all over my life, so. Oh, we don't have time, the bookshop. We're gonna miss the flight if we don't go now, so. Are we running? Oh my God, we're gonna miss the plane. Oh my God, we're gonna miss it. But not really, it's just, I'm being dramatic. I mean, can you notice the splatters of tomato? I don't think so. Don't want to alarm anyone, but I think there might be some rust on the wing. I won't say anything. And just like that, we're here. Welcome to Prague. Streets of Prague, they're busy, they're vibrant. Look at this. This is the expensive street here. We've got all the fancy cars as well. I mean, the Porsches, the G-Wagons, all sorts on this street. It's amazing. For everyone who watches my book reviews, but I've got something special to show you. If you haven't seen it before, check this out. There is currently a queue for it, but it was a tower made of books. Made of books. Look at that. And you can find it yourself here at the Prague Library, and it's not too far away from every other attraction, so make sure you come here and have a look for yourself. It is amazing. is so picturesque. Look at this scenery. Look at this, it's so picturesque. I just can't get over it. This is our first time here, and it is just absolutely beautiful. We're actually on, what is it, Charlie's Bridge, and it's amazing. Get here. Amy has just made a very good point, as we're in Prague, of the architecture here and how modern day architecture isn't the same as what it used to be. I mean, look at this. People actually live in these houses. They live in these buildings. I mean, it's amazing, like the architecture here, of how it hasn't really changed over the past 1,000 years. But they do it on purpose. Modern architecture isn't the same as what it used to be. They do grey buildings, dull buildings, because they're trying to make us that way. They're making us dull. They're making us not want to be motivated by simple things like that. Well, I say simple, so it took forever to build these. It's not exactly easy. But the point of it is that they're trying to dull us down to where we don't be inspired by anything anymore. It's also the same with chained things like restaurants, like McDonald's, KFC, all of that sort of thing, Starbucks. You see it everywhere, and it doesn't make a difference wherever you go, because everywhere looks the same. But when you come to a place like this, and there isn't a Starbucks on every corner, it just makes it that much more special. Thing is, it's the same when we went to London, when we went to Shakespeare's Globe. There was a Cafe Nero pegged to the wall just round the corner. I don't think Shakespeare would have been happy knowing that there was a little, a little cafe just round the corner. Totally overlooking the whole of Prague. It is so beautiful up here. We're about to go up to the tower up there. There's a lot of steps involved. I haven't done any other exercise other than this week. So let's see how that goes. If, like me, you're going to Prague for the first ever time, then you will probably want to go and get yourself a chimney cake. Yes, you heard me right, because I said it right for the first time. This is like the third take. And they are absolutely delicious. I don't know what it is. What is it? It's like bread. It's like bread encased with sugar. And then you can either have a topping or not, but it's up to you. So let's go check out what they're like. Spoiler alert, I have already had one. And boom, just like that, there is a chimney cake. Like I said, it's covered in sugar. This one's filled with ice cream and strawberries. Got to be healthy somewhere. Does that count? So as you can see, inside the cone, it is very bread-like, and it's covered in sugar. All the streets as well here are cobbled, which is really nice, because you can hear the tyres rumble along behind you. But I think that's really aesthetic. It's nice. It's pleasing. The only problem I've really found with it is that it just sounds like everyone's got a flat tyre. So when you actually do have a flat tyre, how do you tell the difference? What I would assume would happen is that your tyre would then go onto your rim, and the rims will get stuck in the tram lines, and then you just have to follow the tram behind. I don't know. Just on our way to try and find the John Lennon Wall, because apparently... Oh, is it up here? Because apparently it is something that we need to see. Ducks. We found it. The Lennon Wall of freedom and energy. Now that's obviously positive vibes, that's what we should all carry through our life, isn't it? You see, the lighting's messed up, so if I just bring that down, you can see the backdrop of Prague. We have all the main attractions behind me. Over there we have Charles's Bridge, or Charlie's Bridge as I called it yesterday. If this is going to be your first time walking up here to, where we go, Petrin Tower. It's Petrin Tower, which is all the way at the top here, to overlook this, apparently even better than what this view is, and this is pretty spectacular. There is benches all the way up, and we have so many steps to climb, or as people coming down. They go very slowly though, as you can see, so that obviously implies that it is very, very steep. I just want to put in a disclaimer right now, is that I'm no tour guide. I mean, this is just for people to keep watching so they find some useful information in it, just where I can help. So please don't comment down below asking which step I went up, because I won't know. I'm not going to know. But I can tell you how beautiful it is, because I think I've said it about 50 times in this video already. Beautiful! This tree behind me, look at the roots. It has been eroded away. All of this stone has been eroded away. People have actually carved their names into this. It's really nice. But the roots themselves, the root system, I don't know if I can bring up the lighting on that, but the root system has still never give up. It hasn't stopped it from creating its foundations to make a solid oak tree. Well, I think it's oak. Is it oak? Someone comment down below. I might be totally wrong, but the message is more important. The message is important of how we should, you know, create strong foundations of what we want to build on, which is what will get us to our next step. Does that make sense? I hope that makes sense. But this is such a good analogy. I mean, it's one that's probably been used over and over, but to look at that and see it in person, it just reminds you with every step that you take. So there we are. There it is, it's the tower. And that's it, we've made it to the tower. There it is, it's just there. Let's go up. Here we go. This is just the beginning. Oh, here's the benches that they said about. And that's it, look at the view. We're at the top of the tower.
No, we're not.
What do you mean, no? Huh?
No, It's not there.
Oh, fuck. Look at... Oh, fuck. Top, you can see us glass away, but this is not for the faint-hearted, because you can feel it wobbling underneath your feet. That's crazy, isn't it? How have they got away with that? Quickie Mart. I mean, if you look, there is actually, there's a poo. I forgot to do a video of it. Here's a sausage. It did have more on it. I've just had some of it. But there's one just not too far down from Charles's Bridge again. So all the food places, they're down here. Check them out. How did you know I was videoing? We're here in Prague by Charles's Bridge and it's absolutely amazing. What the hell is that? What is that? Is that... Is that a beaver? Look at it! It is a beaver! Look, oh. This is nuts! Oh, damn. So here's a top tip, if you're coming to Prague for the first ever time and you want to see a beaver yourself, head down to Charles Bridge. There's a boat over here, it's called the Electric Prague Boats, and you'll see this little guy, look at him. Beavers are us down here, it's brilliant. There's some steps just in this corner, you can come down through the street and come down that way to come see the beaver, look at him. I can't believe this, this is crazy. There we are. Top tip. I didn't think I'd come up with some useful information here, and I have, so you're welcome. We're about to enter, sorry for the colour, a robotic bar. What does that entail? Wherever you go, you've got to make time for the things that you want to do. Jesus Christ. The Rally Sport. Now that is a cool car. And we're just leaving the airport now, back at the UK, which is absolutely amazing because that means I'm going to end the video. So thanks very much for watching. If you've got anything from this, make sure you like and subscribe down below. And I'll hopefully catch you on the channel very, very soon in whatever video that may be. If this has been helpful, make sure you comment down below as well. So thanks for watching and speak to you soon. Cheers.